இப்படி கட்டி இருந்தா கும்பா கட்டி இருந்தா அது மசூதி, உயரமா கட்டி இருந்தா அது வந்து தேவாலயம், நிறைய அசிங்கமான பொம்மைகள் எல்லாம் இருந்தால் அது கோவில், நிறைய அசிங்கமான பொம்மைகள் எல்லாம் இருந்தால் அது கோவில். இப்படி கட்டி இருந்தா கும்பா கட்டி இருந்தா அது மசூதி, உயரமா கட்டி இருந்தா அது வந்து தேவாலயம், நிறைய அசிங்கமான பொம்மைகள் எல்லாம் இருந்தால் அது கோவில்.
I have met so many foreigners who don't quite understand the logic behind the presence of erotic sculptures on the outer walls of some Indian temples. A few years ago, when I first visited some Indian temples, I was absolutely clueless as well. I tried to do some research on my own, but I always felt that I needed to meet an expert. The search for an expert took me to Kerala, which is India's own tropical paradise. Calicut is the native place of the renowned Indian archaeologist K.K. Mohammed, who is the regional director of the Archaeological Survey of India. He is also a recipient of the Padma Shri, which is India's fourth highest civilian honor. Mr. Mohammed explains the significance of symbolism in Hindu temples.
See, the concept of a temple itself is a human concept. Just as you are standing, the temples also will be having many parts, like the feet of you. There'll be temple also will be having a feet. You have a knee, the temple also will be having a knee. So the concept is human concept. It is said, Upapidam Charanakar Adishtanam Janu Mandalam Padavarga Karakaram Prastaram Bahumulagam. So that is the human concept. And inside, you have a deity. So outside, just outside the deity, that is known as Garbhagraha. Just outside this Garbhagraha, there will be two other on one side and two other side also. So the statue on the right side, she would be standing on a crocodile. And the statue on left side, she would be standing on tortoise. So the one standing on crocodile, that is a symbolism of river Ganges. And the one standing on tortoise, that is a symbolism of river Yamuna. So this means you are having a symbolic bath in river Ganga and river Yamuna, and also the unseen Saraswati also, because it is, I mean, you have got that Sangam is there, it is unseen, this one also. So you are having a symbolic bath. You are, I mean, washed of all the sins, and also at the same time, of all that kind of ill feeling which you have got, kama, krodha, and all these things. So you have to set them aside at one particular place, and then you are going towards your God. So that is the concept. For example, if you go to Khajuraho, you have all kinds of things are there, but that is only outside. You don't find things inside. Which means this world is full of all these kinds of things. But now you are in a different world. You are going to a temple. Again, you are having your symbolic washing in Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. And then with a pure mind, you are going towards your own Lord.
In India, the temples in Khajuraho are not the only ones with the erotic imagery on the outer walls. There are various temples in Rajasthan, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Odisha, Chhattisgarh and Gujarat, which also have a similar type of architecture. So what is the solution to the misconceptions regarding Indian culture? Is there something that the Indian administration can do?
So all these things, you know, that has to be explained. And for explaining these things, you know, you have to have a kind of interpretation center, just as you have in Akshardham temples. So that is very essential. That is what I told you. In all the monuments, you know, you have to have a interpretation center where everything is explained either with the help of the films or through a guide, and then take them to the place, you know, they will be having a completely different experience.
Hi, my name is Carolina Goswami. I am doing my best to find accurate and authentic answers regarding many cultural aspects of India which are not fully known or understood. It takes a lot of time, money and effort to do this work. Please come forward and support my mission financially. See you again.